Just to inform the public that we've registered two separate deadly suicide attacks within Kampala City. These attacks occurred today, the 16th of November 2021, at 3 minutes past 10 and at 6 minutes past 10. That is 10:03 a.m. and at 10:06 a.m. respectively. The first attack occurred near the checkpoint at the Central Police Station in Kampala City at around 3 minutes past 10. That was the exact timestamp that we got on the CCTV footages. And when we reviewed the first pictures that came from the CCTV footages after the incident, they clearly revealed how a male adult putting on a black jacket and carrying a backpack detonated himself, detonated the bomb that he was carrying, killing himself instantly. The spillover effect from the bomb covered a radius of about 30 meters, that is from near the checkpoint up to the front desk office at the Central Police Station. Two other people were confirmed dead from that deadly suicide bomb attack near the Central Police Station checkpoint. Those whom we rushed immediately with injuries were 17. That was immediately. And these ones were the ones who were within the section that was covering the point of impact and the front desk area at the Central Police Station. But then the other building also that is adjacent also had other injuries. Another bomb blast occurred within 3 minutes. That was at Parliamentary Avenue, at Raja Chambers and Jubilee Insurance Building, formerly known as the IPS building. And two suicide bombers were clearly captured on motorcycles, two motorcycles. They were disguising as border riders. They detonated the bombs they were carrying on themselves. That killed them instantly. Right now, up to now, our bomb experts and team of forensic experts are still documenting the scene. This is simply because we want to come up with the actual number of victims. We are seeing a lot of bodies shattered, legs have been scattered, and there's a skull which we believe are for the suicide bomber who attacked the police station at CPS. Then there are also other bodies that have been scattered. We can see legs, skulls, and other body parts that have been shattered and scattered at the scene between Raja Chambers and Jubilee Insurance, which we also believe are for the suicide bomb attackers. But outside the suicide bomb attackers at Parliamentary Avenue, at least we are confirming that there's an extra body, which we believe is for a civilian. So right now we are still talking about three bodies of people that are dead, three suicide attackers who killed themselves, and the total so far of the injured persons we've rushed to Mulago National Referral Hospital has increased up to 33. So far, 33 are injured, and 5 are critically injured. Now, bosses, like we indicated, have been cordoned by our joint counter-terror teams. And first of all, we want to extend our thoughts to those who have lost their loved ones, the three who have so far died. And we want to also wish a speedy recovery to the 33 who are injured and the 5 who are critically injured amongst the 33. Now, you are all aware that these attacks come 22 days after the last suicide attack on Usif Safari Bus. The hallmarks of the attack clearly indicate that the ADF-linked radicalized groups who still have a desire to carry out lethal attacks on soft targets using suicide attackers and improvised explosive devices behind these attacks.